In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, Similar Triangles. Our directions are to state if the triangles in each pair are similar. If so, state how you know they are similar and complete the similarity statement. So there are three ways we know that triangles are similar. The first way is the angle-angle or AA postulate. That says that if two angles in one triangle are congruent to two angles in another triangle, then the triangles must be similar. So this is angle-angle. The next one we have is side-side-side. So if three sides of one triangle are proportional to the corresponding three sides of another triangle, then the triangles are similar. And lastly, side-angle-side, SAS for short. Side-angle-side says that if the included angle is congruent to an included angle in another triangle, and the sides that include that angle are proportional to the other two sides that include that angle, then the triangle is similar. So knowing that, let's get started with number one. In number one, we can see that this angle is congruent to this angle because SUT and DUE are vertical angles and vertical angles are congruent. And they give us the sides. So this will be SAS if the sides are proportional. So we need to see if 16 over 16 is proportional to 40 over 39. And I know that 16 over 16 is 1, and 1 does not equal 40 over 39. Therefore, number 1, the two triangles are not similar because the sides are not proportional. Therefore, we do not need to complete this similarity statement. Let's move on to number 2. In number 2, we're given the length of sides of each of the triangles, so we're going to need to see if they are proportional. So we'll take this longer side AC, which is 84, over the shortest side, 48. Is that proportional to the longest side HF, 14, over the shortest side in the second triangle, 8? So now we're going to cross multiply and see if this is true. So we'll have 84 times 8. Is that equal to 48 times 14? 84 times 8 is 672, and 48 times 14 is also 672. So those sides are indeed proportional. Now we need to check that third side. So we'll do the long side 84 over that third side 72. Is that to the long side 14 over that third side of 12? So we're going to have 84 times 12. Is that equal to 14 times 72? 84 times 12 is 1008, and 14 times 72 is also 1008. Therefore, all three sides are proportional to the three sides of another triangle. So these two triangles are indeed similar. And they're similar, why? Because of SSS similarity, side-side-side similarity theorem. So now we can complete this statement. Triangle CBA is similar to triangle FGH. And when we're writing what triangles are similar, we want to keep the vertex in order. So angle C is congruent to angle F, so C and F are listed first. Angle B is congruent with angle G, so those are listed. And then lastly, A and H. Or you could just go off the sides. Smallest side to the second smallest side to the largest side, C, B to A. Smallest side to the second smallest side to the largest side, F, G, H. Let's move on to number 3. In number 3, we can see that angle MVL is congruent to angle TVU, and that's because of the vertical angle theorem. So those angles are congruent. Now we just need to see if the sides are proportional. So is this side TV with a length of 49 over the side of 28, is that proportional to 14 over 8? Larger side over the smaller side, larger side over the smaller side. Now we're going to cross multiply. 49 times 8, is that equivalent to 28 times 14? 49 times 8 is 392, and is that equal to 28 times 14? 28 times 14 is also 392. So yes, they are equivalent and therefore proportional. So these two triangles are indeed similar. And note that we used SAS. We have side, angle, side, side, angle, side. The two angles, which are included, are congruent and the sides are proportional. So this is SAS similarity. And we can say indeed that triangle VUT is similar to triangle VLM. And again, when we're writing out that triangle, V to U, U to T, and then the largest side T to V. So we're going to do V to L, the shorter side, L to M, and then that largest side, M to V. So VLM. And number four, we have the angle T is congruent to angle J, and we have the angle U is congruent to angle K. So right away, these two triangles are similar. And that's because of the angle-angle similarity postulate that says that if two angles of one triangle are congruent to two angles of another triangle, then those triangles are similar. So we can say, well, angle J corresponds to T, angle K corresponds to U, and angle L corresponds to V. J, K, L, T, U, V are similar. And number five, we can say that angle UST is congruent to angle CSB. B has one mark, T has two marks, and U has three marks. So none of the other angles are congruent, and we're not given any side lengths. Therefore, we cannot say that these triangles are similar. We are not able to use SSS, SAS, or angle-angle similarity. Now we'll look at number six. We're looking at this large triangle, KLM. Is that similar to the smaller triangle, KBC? Well, we know that angle K is congruent to itself. So in both triangles, we have the included angle is congruent. Now we just need to look at the side length. This side of 16 over this side of the smaller triangle, 25, is that proportional to the large triangle length, 88, over this large length, K to M, which is 25 plus 107. 25 plus 107 is equal to 132. So 16 over 25, is that proportional to 88 over 132? Cross multiply. 16 will get multiplied to 132. Is that equal to 25 times 88? 16 times 132 is 2,112. 25 times 88 is 2,200. So no, those sides are not equivalent. Therefore, these two triangles are not similar. And I'll stop the video ending on this first page. Join me in the next video where I'll complete the second page of this worksheet. And if you haven't already, click that subscribe button, like this video, and share it if you think somebody else will find it useful.